هيا على الفلاح.
Person. A good person is he or she who does not harm others. If you cannot benefit them, at least don't harm them. Like I always say, the ulama who struggle and who strive to help the ummah and they perhaps benefit us in so many different ways, one small thing and we start speaking bad about them, bad mouthing them in such a bad way that sometimes the matter is not even true. And they have only helped us. What did they do to harm you? What did the man do to harm you? You are talking bad about him today. Say something good. He did not harm you. Same applies when we meet people and they are glad to meet us. They know that only goodness will come from this person. And we will be saved from any harm. They will never harm us. In that particular case, we have become from the best. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and this is a very powerful narration, I'm sure we all know it off by heart, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. Two words repeated, and the last word is connected to your spouse. The best from amongst you is the best from amongst you to his spouse. Subhanallah. You know the term ahl here? It refers, yes, to your wife, but by extension it refers to your family. How many of us are best to our family? My beloved brothers, I want to take a moment to address you. And I know the sisters also would benefit from it. But my beloved brothers, how many of us are guilty of being nice to the women of the world, to show them what we have, to reach out to them, without reaching out to the women whom Allah has blessed us with in our own home? So we turn around and we don't even appreciate our wives. We look at them, we look at our children, our wives, our family members, we don't commend them or pass a good comment or at least say, you know what, I think you look gorgeous, I think you're good, mashallah, you're dressed so well, mashallah, you're smelling good, what's this, subhanallah, or smile at them. But for the others, what do? Subhanallah, you go to work, first thing, woo, you look lovely, who's that? Someone who doesn't perhaps even look that lovely. But it gave you a kick because shaitan was there spoiling you from being khayrukum. If you did it at home, you became khayrukum. And if you did it where you were not supposed to do it, you might just become sharrukum. You might become the worst. So go out of your way to appreciate the people you live with, your family members. They need reassurance. I remember once there was a brother who told me, you know, I cannot commend my wife on her smell because every time I go home, she is smelling of onions and food and that which is cooked and oil and so on. So how do you want me to tell her you are smelling good? Do you know what happened? I told him, brother, in that case, you tell her, I'm sure you have cooked such a delicious meal because you are a brilliant cook. Subhanallah, you need to appreciate why she may be smelling of food. She's been in the kitchen preparing food for who? For the neighbor? No, for you. Subhanallah. So if you really want to admire that, get a cook or get food from outside and tell her, listen my love, here I've got you the best perfume from wherever and you may apply this. We are not going to be cooking from this day on in this kitchen. Seal it. We're buying food from outside. We're getting a cook and he will come or she will come and cook so that I can actually praise you every day regarding the smell. Subhanallah. We need to understand the balance. Obviously, my beloved sisters, you cannot use my statement in order to oppress your men. Subhanallah. I need to balance this because we have to be kind to one another. It's a balance. So what I'm saying is, yes, we acknowledge one another. And we must know that the roles being fulfilled are extremely important. Sometimes, and I always like to preach this, you know, my family tells me, subhanallah, that yes, you have said it, we want to see you do it. You know what I say? Once in a while, you need to cook too. In Ghana, the men will say, what? Are you crazy? Me? Cooking? Wallahi, my brother, even if the only thing you know how to make is eggs, make it. Subhanallah. Once in a while, cook, I promise you. Show an interest in it, no matter who you are. I've tried to do it myself, and guess what? My eggs are not that bad. Alhamdulillah. My brothers and sisters, it's important. We're talking about the best of you, being the best character, being the best to your spouse. Think of what to do to make your family happy. Think of it. And that is when you will be successful. When the family is happy, community will be happy. Why should we fall in the trap of the devil, making us praise the people who, subhanallah, are not deserving of our own praise more than our spouse? You might want to commend someone else after you have commended those who you meant to begin with. Subhanallah. What's happening in society? I commend someone else's wife and someone is commending my wife. So nothing's going right. Then I want to blame people for having an affair. Well, she's not getting any attention from anyone besides a stranger. But my brothers and sisters, be careful, be careful, be careful of technology. Use it correctly. Use it to educate yourselves. Don't use it to break your homes. Don't use it in a way that you know you have fallen prey to the devil and his plan. For then we cannot be calling ourselves the best. Your relationships online are very, very serious. Remember, a lot of those who might pretend to be a female may actually be a male. A lot of those who pretend to be someone, they are just people to trap you. I recall one day, a certain brother told me how much money he has donated to me online. And I told him, I didn't collect any money online. He says, but I've been chatting with you on Facebook. I says, I don't chat on Facebook. But who is it? I said, hang on. You need to know who you are dealing with. If you search my name, there might be 100 profiles with the same name. But if you see the one that is verified, it has a blue tick next to it, yes, you know you are talking to me. And in that case, perhaps you won't even find a response because of the time. I will be speaking to the people of Ghana rather than spending my time, you know, chatting to say hello and how are you to so many people on the globe personally, one-on-one. It is impossible. So you need to be intelligent. People have lost their money online. People have lost their marriages online. People have lost their lives online. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Strengthen yourselves. Develop your character, your conduct. And like I said, you'd rather spend that time at home. One more thing I want to mention regarding this point before we move to the next. Brothers and sisters, when you are at home and you have a meal, you are having a meal, put your phone away. Put your phone away. I challenge you. I challenge all of you. And the challenge is for myself too. When you are at home having a meal with your family, put the phone away if it means for 10, 15, 20 minutes. How many of us, we're on the table, next to us is the phone. Fair enough if it is turned off or silent. But every little while we are speaking on the phone. It is an anticlimax. Trust me, your children, they are maltreated. You are usurping from their time and their right. It is the right of the children that you spend time with them. You teach them table manners. How is that going to happen when you yourself have spoken on the phone throughout the meal, every meal, if at all you've had the meal with them? A lot of us are delayed. We are busy on our phones. They are waiting for us for the meal. Please come to eat. Whether it's dad or mama, whoever, we don't go. They call us again. Then they all are sitting and eating and we are still not gone. And then they finish eating and after that, we decide, hey, what happened? Food, you guys didn't wait for me. Hang on, we called you 30 times. And 30 times you just said yes, yes, yes. We don't know whether you were saying yes to what. One of the times we told you, you are stupid, you said yes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. See, we don't even know what's being said sometimes. So my brothers and sisters, let's remember the best from amongst you, those who are best to their family members. One might think, is there a contradiction between all of these? The answer is no. When you've learned the Quran, you have the best character, you will have the best character, you will be the best to your family members, etc. Let's move to another one. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ أَطْعَمَ الطَّعَامَ وَرَدَّ السَّلَامَ. The best from amongst you, and all this is part of good character, those who feed food and those who respond to the salam. Someone says, assalamu alaikum, and you just look away. Gone.
وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا.
Of mankind. The hadith says, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ, not even from amongst you. Wait. Notice, this includes Muslims, non-Muslims. If you are the most beneficial to them, you are the best. So the best of mankind, those who are the best to the rest of mankind, that's simple. Subhanallah. Again, ask yourself, am I really beneficial to everyone? If you are, good news to you. And this includes, like I said, the non-Muslims. Because definitely when they see the character and conduct of a Muslim, the minimum is they will recognize the value of this beautiful heavenly religion. Let's not be from among those who cheat and deceive, bad mouth. We say bad words, vulgar words. A swear word is never meant to be uttered by the mouth of he or she who reads the Shahada.